present space program. I didn't see myself as a black, and I didn't see myself as a woman. Here I was involved in projecting a future of what our space program could, where it could take us, and I wanted to be there, not in fantasy, not 300 years from today, but now.
But NASA said that women weren't
so it was 1977. NASA was struggling to recruit scientists, engineers, and astronauts for the new space shuttle program. So Nichelle Nichols, Star Trek's Lieutenant Uhura, challenged them. She goes, "Where are my people?"
Isn't that incredible? Yeah. So she was on this personal mission and recruiting 8,000 of the nation's best and brightest, who became the first African American, Asian, and Latino men and women to fly in space.
Very cool. Cleveland native, filmmaker Todd Thompson telling her story. And of course, he's here with us today.
Hey.
Grew up
Welcome.
In Parma. You're going to be at the Chagrin Falls Film Festival coming up.
Yeah, we're there. We had a screening last night. Our first, it's like a hometown sneak peek. Nobody's seen the film. We just finished it about a month ago.
How'd it go?
It was great. You know, I had, you know, a couple friends from high school showed up, which was really cool.
Oh, that's so neat.
My family's coming out. We're having another screening on Sunday.
What time is the screening Sunday?
It's Sunday, October 6th at 12 noon.
Okay.
Yeah, at the Chagrin Falls Intermediate School. They have a big, really cool, big high-tech auditorium there that they're showing it in.
Well, and it's nice, too, because the people can ask you questions after.
Yeah, there's
Q&A
after,
really engage
exactly.
you. And first of all, this is such a great topic. We were all watching it yesterday. We watched the trailer. As I'm talking, you have goosebumps to see how much power she had in NASA. Who knew? This is a story telling her story, which we didn't know any of this.
Yeah, when I got the phone call like 4 years ago about this story, you know, a proposal to, hey, we're gonna, it was a phone call from my producing partner, Tim Franta, and you know, you call someone, you're like, hey, would you like to do, it was, hey, we're gonna do a story about Nichelle Nichols, what she did for NASA. At the time, we were trying to get it done in time for the Star Trek 50th, but that didn't work out. But I'm happy that it didn't work out that way, actually, because we found a lot of great content after the fact that we would have missed out on had it not taken 4 years to finish the film.
4 years.
It was a 4-year journey, but it was an extremely humbling journey. Nichelle's amazing. I mean, an absolute beautiful person.
I have to tell you, and watching, I kept saying that she's gorgeous.
Yeah.
She's just such a beautiful woman.
And you know, she welcomes you into her home very regally, and we spent, you know, quite a bit of time there over the last 4 years, you know, just working with her and interviewing her. She was a co-producer on the film, so, you know, we were very involved with her the whole way, but amazing woman, yeah.
And so she was able to kind of, through her Star Trek fame, recruit people. And she actually pointed people out. She goes, I want you. You need to be in this. And it was really that catalyst that helped brought the space program to where it is today.
Yeah, because I mean, a lot of minorities, African Americans, Latinos, Asians, women, you know, they never really thought NASA was for them.
Mm-hmm.
And it was her job to go around and say, no, it is for you, and you should apply. And so she did a 4-month campaign around the country. I mean, literally zigzagging around the country for four months, and she had over 8,000 applicants. And at the time, leading up to the space shuttle program, NASA only had about 1,000.
Mm.
So imagine what she did in 4 months.
And she's like just an unsung hero of the program and of so many people that she really
100%
activated.
Yeah. And what she did changed the face of the space program.
Yes.
But what it really did was it changed the world forever, because the minute, you know, the general public sees women and African Americans and Asians and people like me, you know, in space, you know, anything's possible at that
mm-hmm.
point.
If
they can do it, I can do it too.
Mm-hmm.
Did she know her own power?
I don't think she feels that way or thinks that way. I think she just has a very core belief in something, a passion for something, and she just goes out and gets it, you know, manifests it. And she says that in the film, actually. You know, something that she fantasized about for such a long time and turned into reality, which is the way it works, you know.
It's amazing. Well, we're happy to have you back home. You grew up in Parma.
Great.
Your
it's cold
dad
today, though.
It is.
I know.
I'm like a Florida boy now.
I know. We're all right. Your dad Gary is so sweet. Yeah. It's been a pleasure to meet
him. Yeah, he's my publicist, you know. He sets up nice interviews for me.
Before we go, just real quick, we love the Dr. King story, the connection with Nichelle Nichols too. Could you just express that, let people know what they're going to see like that?
Well, so what was interesting was when Nichelle got on Star Trek, she was excited because she was an actress and she got a job. But what happened very quickly was her role just immediately got diminished. So these scripts would start off with robust scenes and dialogue, and it always boiled down to like yes captain, no captain type dialogue. So, you know, after the first year, any artist would probably get tired of that.
Sure.
And so she resigned. She sent in her resignation. And she was at an NAACP event out in California, one of the first, and got a tap on the shoulder from a fan. And she goes, "Oh, I'm not here for Star Trek right now." And this guy really wanted to meet her. And he turned around, and it was Dr. King. And he literally took her aside and said, "Listen, on Monday you're going to go back and get your job back, because here is your role is so important for what America is seeing on television today. You don't realize, like, 20 years from now what the effect of you being on TV today is going to have on people." And he was right. You know, he had that foresight and that vision. And so she.
And you talk about the kiss.
Oh yeah, well, yeah. Yeah. So yeah, and then of course, you know, with the episode, Gene Roddenberry. I mean, with Star Trek, was able to explore so many different social topics that he couldn't do in a present-day TV show. It had to be something set in the 23rd century. So, you know, to have a white and African-American person kiss on TV for the first time was pretty dramatic.
Yes.
For the time.
The showing is this Sunday at the Chagrin Falls Film Festival. It's at the Intermediate School Theater there. Woman in Motion. Todd, thank you so much for joining us.
Oh, it's
very
cool.
Yeah,
it's
welcome home.
Yes, thank you very much. Enjoy your visit.
Thanks. Back
home.
Good to be here.
Good, great.